Hello, everybody, and welcome back to XCOM 2 Long War 2. I'm Liz, we're on the Avenger. We just completed the first liberation mission in New Arctic, and we are going to head back there and keep scanning. We have 223 intel, we have no contacts, and we have no supplies available to expand that. So when we get supplies, they're going to be going into a resistance communications. What's our power situation, anyway?
What can I do for you, Commander?
I have enough engineers, so I should have people assigned to the power relay. Yeah, we got power. We can get a resistance comms. If I go for a workshop here, the workshop will supply this, 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 and this. The proving grounds is already occupied, so we put like resistance comms here, maybe. Or I just put the workshop here and I put resistance comms here and say, you know what? Too bad, Guerrilla Tactics School. You're not going to get anything. And then the proving grounds would be supplied all the time. Then we get three things. Laboratory, shadow chamber, which means that this space, and this space would be unoccupied for other things. I think we just put the workshop there, so we'll put the comm station here. I think is how we're gonna do this, and we'll put something else that needs engineers below it, so it's gonna have three adjacencies, which will be enough for our purposes. So all we really need is 100, no, not 100 supplies, 125 supplies, so basically 100-ish supplies, and we will get ourselves a resistance comms. We can't afford that Psi Lab yet. I'm sorry guys, we can't do it yet. We just can't. One Illyrium core, very nice. Alright. Let's scan here. We want that next liberation mission as soon as possible. We recruited somebody. Advent Midnight Raids. Crackdown on resistance recruitment. Increasing the cost of recruits by 100%. Okay, so that doesn't actually affect the other thing. We just recruited somebody, I think is what that said. Where? We recruited somebody at New Arctic, where I'm not recruiting anybody. Sophia, so you're a faceless then, I'm guessing, right? Well, go work on intel for the time being, because you negate intel the same no matter what. I really wish you could set the Haven to automatically assign these people, because if you do end up recruiting somebody, they just sit hiding for a while. Although hiding could be good, it does help to reduce advent strength in the area. And with this many people working intel, liberation, rescue a defector. So this is the second tier liberation mission. It got down to 5 days, 4 hours, though. It should have spawned with like 18-ish days. Rescue VIP from Advent Cell. Liberation, rescue a defector. Light, moderate. And we're going to get a scientist for it, which is exactly what I need. The enemy activity does go up, though, for these missions. I might actually spend intel on this. I might infiltrate this and spend intel to try and bring activity down to make it just a little smidgen easier. But we're going to go on this mission, and we are sending a boss of a team. Let's pick this team out. So Flipper is still wounded for a day, so we'll send Pasha again. It's okay. Flipper's awesome, but we can send Pasha. We're going to be sending Haas, though. Yeah, Haas is a higher rank. First lieutenant. Dutch is a second lieutenant. Haas only has one use of command, though, which sucks. Oh, well. We're going to be sending Haas, who's going to get a new call sign at the same time Flipper does, so we're not going to do it yet. We're going to send Pasha. We're going to send Butcher. Where's Butcher? Butcher. Awesome. Go. Warhorse. How many days do we have left? We have just over 1 day left, so I could probably afford one more person relatively easily. And if I was to do that, I'd probably want to bring a specialist. Yeah, okay. So I can afford this. I could probably afford to send one more person if I'm going to use intel on this. And I think I want to use intel on this. I've got a lot of intel, and I want to sort of make this as straightforward of one as we can. So if I was to bring one more person, what would it be? A sharpshooter, probably? Or a gunner? Would we want Flounder? I would take Giggles if Giggles was available. Because Giggles has Cyclic Shot. Do I want to bring Flounder? She doesn't have that, but I can get her that ability. Alternatively, we can bring Maria. Yeah, maybe I just bring a sharpshooter. See, the thing is, Flounder's only got 13 movement. And the next gunner down is a Haven Advisor, that's Nuke. Then I have a Backfire here who's got 14 movement, he's a rank below Flounder. And he's really only got that one extra movement. Whereas I can take Maria, who's got 15 movement, who's a sharpshooter. She's a damn good ground sharpshooter, but you know, she'd be okay. Yeah, well, we'll take her. It's fine. She has a damn good ground one, right? No, it's somebody else who's the damn good ground one. Yeah, you're a precision shot, dead shot, center mass sniper, so that's fine. So now we're going to make all items available. We're going to make upgrades available. And let's start equipping you guys. So you've already got combat awareness, which is exactly what we want on you. But we're going to use a Predator Armor. You have your laser rifle that has the Elite Scope, Elite Hair Trigger, and Expanded Magazine. I'm going to try and get you a better Expanded Magazine. Just give me a little bit of time. You are going to wear alloy plating. You're not going to bring the medkit. You're going to bring... Well, I'd bring you Venom rounds if we had them, but I'm going to get you the Tracer rounds. And you're going to bring the TAC vest. So when you are in Overwatch, you're going to have 1, 2 for being in Overwatch, 3 armor, and 4 if you have the ability that gives you an extra armor. Do you have that ability? No. You get that ability at the next level. Formidable. So you're going to have 4 armor in Overwatch when you level up, which could be insane. That could be insane. So expanded mag. We have an advanced expanded mag. Yep, that's what it's going to be. The reason expanded magazines, by the way, are better than autoloaders for a ranger, the way that I'm building them. I haven't actually explained this in detail yet, but let's go to soldier abilities here. It's this perk right here at Master Sergeant, Kill Zone. Take a reaction shot against any enemy that moves or attacks within a cone of fire. This was a vanilla XCOM 2 ability that snipers got. You lay down a cone on the ground, like an area of effect, and that's your turn. Although you can put it as your second action as a ranger after, you know, shooting, for example. And whenever enemies move through it, you'll take a shot at them. If 5 enemies move through it, you'll shoot 5 times. But you're limited by the ammo you have. So if you have a really big magazine, you can shoot every enemy on the map, basically. So by opening up with like a saturation fire from a gunner and then a kill zone on top of them with the ranger, you can just murder entire squads like they were nothing. You're going to get yourself some Pred armor. I'm going to give you a Sten gun, which I will look into upgrading once I've done everything else. I'm going to give you the Ionic Axe. You're going to get an alloy plating. And a hazmat vest. And your final thing here is probably the battle scanner. Yep, battle scanner. We'll look into his weapon upgrades in a bit. Let's get our other people loaded out first. What's your PCS? Do you have a PCS? Yeah, focus, just because I didn't have anything better for you at the time. Hyperreactive pupils, aim after a miss, impact fields, activate to reduce incoming, that's not bad. Hyperreactive pupils, smart macrophages, immunity to acid and poison. That's not a bad one. Emergency life support, which is good. Speed for mobility. Cool. I could give that speed one to an assault who has shitty mobility to make them okay, or I can give it to somebody who has good mobility to make them exceptional. Like you. Your mobility is 15. I could give you this speed one to give you exceptional mobility. Or I could give you smart macrophages. Which is what I think I'm going to give you. Either that or impact fields. Fuck it. We're just going to give you smart macrophages. So you are immune to acid and poison. And you're going to recover faster between battles. Which means I don't have to give you hazmat vests. Not that I was going to give you a hazmat vest anyway, but I really don't need to give you hazmat vests. What? You've got an advanced laser sight. I'm actually going to take that off of this because you're definitely not using that, you're definitely not using that conventional shotgun. Arc thrower, you get the other outlet plating. Talon rounds, because shotgun. And you get the nanoscale vest so that you can't really be crit very easily, and you should not look like this at all. You look like a scrub. Let's just do your weapon upgrade first. So we've got elite autoloader, advanced stock, advanced laser sight, so I don't have an elite laser sight. Nine. Okay, so we're gonna use an advanced laser sight. I guess we can give you an elite autoloader, right? Doesn't really affect you all that much. I don't think we need to put an elite autoloader in this mission, though. Let's give you a regular autoloader. And, an advanced suppressor just to reduce your infiltration time, I guess. I mean, reducing our infiltration costs would be good. And then we're going to customize you real quick, and your props, your torso, absolutely cannot look like that. That is disgusting. You are a soldier. Look like a frickin' soldier. Shinobis? Maybe. Shinobis are like independent, act alone, supposed to be scary looking motherfuckers. I would still rather them look, you know, mysterious than spiky, but maybe a shinobi, but not fucking you. Alright, so I'm going out with the Predator armor on this one. Laser Sten Gun, you're gonna get an advanced suppressor for sure, because Grenadiers have after sparks the biggest impact on mission times. So you got plasma grenades, frag grenades, ceramic plating, and a flashbang grenade. Is that what we want? We're gonna take the plasma grenades. Instead of the frag grenades, we're gonna bring the frost bomb. Yeah. Alright, you're good to go. Combat sims, what do we give you? Are any of these really going to do any good? I mean, we could give you superior focus or emergency life support. Me, watch, this is the... we're going to give you superior focus. Because I might as well use them. If I'm not going to use them, I should just sell them, right? Which might be a good idea, I do need money. You know? Combat sims. I'm tempted to give you that, but then you're the person who's going to have the medkits. So let's look at your loadout. You're going to get Predator armor. I'm going to have a laser rifle for you for sure, so I'm going to give you a laser rifle. You're going to get the Mark II Gremlin. I don't have any more alloy plating. You do get the medkit, and you get the Skulljack. So no nanoscale vest for you. You've only got 9 HP. That does mean I have a nanoscale vest available for another one, though. I'm not going to equip your gun with anything special yet. You could be okay having that on you, I suppose. If you happen to miss, you'd be really good on the next turn. Let's check your loadout real quick. Predator armor. You've got a laser lance with advanced stock, autoloader, and scope. I might be able to do a little better than that. We'll see. You're going to bring a medkit, ceramic plating, and the laser pistol. And I think that's right. Yeah, that's right. So you've only got 8 HP, but you also will hopefully not be in the line of fire very often. You don't have any pistol abilities, really. Yeah, I'm content with that. Weapon upgrade. Do I have a better stock? Like, do I have an elite stock? Apparently not. Autoloader scope. I definitely have one more elite scope. I've got a lot of advanced scopes. We're gonna give you an advanced scope. I have more than enough elite and advanced scopes for my rangers, so... Yeah, and a single autoloader should be sufficient, but I know I have advanced autoloader as well, so we'll do that. An advanced stock. So you've got an advanced out sniper rifle, which is awesome. Then I think you are set with what you need. So, some changes we need to make to our people. We are actually over the infiltration time by a good amount right now. Who has mods free? You've got a mod free, and you actually need to have your weapon upgraded. You're gonna get the best suppressor we have, which is where? Advanced suppressor, because you're a grenadier. Even if you're carrying a sub, having the best suppressor we have is good. The shinobi, the suppressor has the least impact on your weapon, but we're still going to give you a suppressor. I have four, so we're going to do it. You have weapon upgrades available, so let's go there, and you're going to get a suppressor. In addition to, you might as well get something else as well, right? Not an advanced scope. Maybe we just give you a scope and a hair trigger? Yeah, that makes sense. A scope and a regular hair trigger. We got lots of all of those. We can actually probably start selling some. Just as long as we have enough to do the foundry project, we should be fine. And yours is maxed out already. So we are what? 15 hours over infiltration. We will spend intel. We will be well over fully infiltrated once we spend intel, to the point where we should gain some bonuses from it. And this gives us the ability to have an extra person on the field, and I like that. So let's do this. We've got a fully kitted out squad for this mission. It's a super important one. Let's start the infiltration. Normally, when I don't have any infiltration going already, and I am starting a recording, and I start an infiltration, I like to cut out the squad selection for it, because I know it's going to take me a while to do squad selection, and the mission, I'm still going to have a shit ton more base work to do before we get to any mission, but I wanted you to see that squad being built. Of all squads, I wanted that one to be seen. Wow. Okay, so this is going to counter a hidden event. Recover item from advent facility. Attack counterinsurgency op. Counters a hidden event. Yeah, we're gonna do this. We got 19 days. We're gonna fully fucking infiltrate this one. We're gonna bring it down to extremely light as well because of how much we infiltrate it. This squad I'm gonna build off camera, and I will, I'll pick the soldiers. We're gonna have Dutch go in with, Clutch. Do I have an assault that I would want to bring to this mission? I've got Crash. Yeah, let's bring Crash. Defcon. Rogue. Flounder. It's going to be extremely light opposition. I don't think we need more than this squad. And these are actually pretty high-ranking people. I could probably afford to bring some lower-ranking people, given how much we're going to be infiltrating this. But it's not like Flounder is our highest-ranking gunner either. I'll equip these people, and I'll be right back. Alright, here's what we got. We have Predator Armor on our Ranger and our Shinobi. To make up for the fact that he doesn't have Predator Armor, Crash is going to have the nanoscale vest. Grenadier, no special grenades available. We're going to bring a smoke grenade on Rogue for utility purposes and a medkit. That's the only medkit I currently have. You know what? You are not going to bring a flashbang in this slot. You're going to bring a medkit. I want a medkit on a second soldier. Talon rounds, of course, because I have another one available. We could have brought something on the Shinobi potentially as well. Flashbang here on Dutch. Boltcaster on the specialist for this mission. I don't know where the laser cannon is. I'm thinking at this point maybe it's on a Haven Advisor, but I'm going to have to investigate that closely because I cycle through my roster and I can't find it. But it's clearly available when I build items. So, yeah, that's a thing. We're going to start this infiltration, though. And we've got a lot of time for it. Like, that one is going to be fully infiltrated, guaranteed, hands down. So let's scam. Communication from the Resistance. So it's a security breach. Yeah, rendezvous. Ambush Advent Forces. I guess this is good, because that means I don't have to wait for one of these infiltrations to be done. And this will kill a faceless in the area, so that's good. Guess what? I found the laser cannon in the pre-mission loading screen. The Advent spy has been tracked to a meeting site. Blah, 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 blah.
Squad concealed.
Right here. Elena. Nuke has the laser cannon. She's also got predator armor on, which is awesome. She's got center mass. She has halo bullets. I've got a little bit more firepower in this mission than I had in the last one. Let's just say that. What do our guys have? Oh, what grenade did you have? You had a flashbang. Okay. So you've got a frag and two flashbangs, so you must be a level 2 with the flashbanger perk if that's the case. I can't see any modifications on you, so whatever. You also have precision shot, so you're definitely a level 2. You have a flashbang and a frag, and also an assault rifle. Assault rifle with a flashbang and a frag. You've got a flashbang and a frag with an assault rifle. And finally, flashbang, frag, and an assault rifle. So we don't have any smoke grenades. That's okay, though. We don't desperately need them or anything. Let's move into positions. We've got a building here. We've got some low ground over here that, you know, they could be in. I don't know. I guess we'll find out soon enough. I don't have any submachine gun soldiers here, which is kind of lame. I definitely enjoy having subs. Subs are good. Really good. Doesn't reveal anything by dashing up to there.
Already there.
Doesn't reveal anything by going to there.
Let's do this.
Doesn't reveal anything by going to there. Okay.
Move to designated position.
Well then, let's take some extra dashes, shall we?
All over it.
Yeah, and the person who probably needs to be at the front to make sure we fuck things up the most. They don't usually patrol too far in these missions. They stay close to where, you know, the meeting site is supposed
That's
to happen. They patrol a little bit. Still no reveal. I'm thinking it's out in this direction, but the meeting could be up in this direction, or it could be a combination of the both. Here's the Advent security station, which is common on these maps, like that little hut, basically, that they use.
Location confirmed.
No reveal. Well, since you're committed up there, we basically should put the rest of our resources close to you, right?
Moving to designated coordinates.
What's important right now is that we find them, I suppose. We don't need to engage them. We can choose the turn we engage. The last rendezvous mission we did with the technical and the three dudes and only one of them had an assault rifle. That one, I absolutely had to take advantage of the fact that I got to choose the engagement. Okay, so you, I would love to get high ground on them, but you might not be able to do it.
Moving out.
Depends how far away they are. Do you see them? You don't. Yeah, so no, we're not going to manage that. We're going to have to come up to, like, here. In fact, let's just do it. Okay, we spotted them. Hopefully they didn't spot us.
Hostiles making the rounds.
No reveal. Awesome. So they've got a sentry and two troopers. 3 health, 4 health, and 4 health, was it? Alright, well, I don't have grenades or rockets or any of that good juicy stuff to slap these guys with, but it's okay. I'll slap them with my balls. You know? Because my balls like to slap things. But
copy that. Got it. Moving.
Yeah, if you can dash and get all the way up there, dash and get all there, please. If you don't have the movement to get all the way up there, get somewhere useful.
Solid copy.
Okay, so where do they patrol? They're going to the left. That is one pop culture reference that is not going to cause me to break into song, because that's a fucking awful song. Anyway, now that we've freaked out enough. Yeah, I'm going to move you to here. It's a safe move. For show, for show. I'm going to put you here. Also a safe move. Totally safe move. Nothing could possibly go wrong with that move, guys. It's the safest move there is.
I'm on the move.
This prevents you from sidestepping here, but you can sidestep here, and from this position you should be able to shoot anything reasonable.
No need to ask twice.
I would love to, you know, use a awesome pulling ability like Iron Curtain here, but I don't know if I should. What do you see? You can see some targets, that's good. And you. I guess you pretty much just have to move up to here, right?
Go, go, go.
Okay, so if we pull with Iron Curtain, our gunner is out of the picture, but we will do some damage to open. They won't be able to move very far, and we can use our other people for good shit.
Scanning.
It all depends on where they go, I guess. If we can't actually hit them with Iron Curtain, it's for naught, right? It's a moot point. Moot. Who remembers moot? I remember moot. You don't have Iron Curtain. Okay, never mind. Cancel that. I'm just silly. We're pulling with a grenade. We are absolutely, definitely, 100% pulling with a grenade. The thing is, if I ambush, this attack may critically hit. I don't need a crit. Okay, I don't need a crit here, and it doesn't have any better chance of hitting, so we're not going to use that ability. Can you hit them all with a grenade? No, we actually need to be closer to do that. And we can't really get closer, so maybe we don't hit them with a grenade, maybe we just overwatch the shit out of them. In which case, if we're going to overwatch the shit out of them, then yeah, we're going to use ambush on you on the sentry. And we're going to get everybody else into a position where they can shoot. So you need to have a shot. If you don't have a shot, you need to move to get a shot right now. Okay, you should still have a shot from here. Yep. Okay, do it. If this gives me vision on the next group, though, yeah, no, good, we're fine. And you'll have a shot from here. These two need to move up where they will get a shot.
Moving to designated position.
Yep.
That's affirmative.
Awesome. And you are going to take the first shot, I think. Well, I think you take the first shot and they overwatch is what we're going to do. I know you can ambush him, but you can crit without the overwatch.
Eyes on the prize.
You're going to have just as good a chance to crit right now, so let's overwatch on everybody else except for you, and we could hail of bullets technically, then you won't crit at all, but I think we go after this guy. He has a scope, so he has an advent scope, +5 aim, persistent effect, would be great to just fucking kill him. Do it. Nice. 9 damage. There's loot on all of these guys. I never mentioned that, but there's loot on all of these guys. All right, two more kills. Come on, guys. Fight for your haven. Show me how good the resist... Wow. That was really bad, guys. Like, awful. Two faceless. Shit. Are you not in Overwatch?
Cover's blown.
Do troopers get Shadow Step? They must. We were still concealed. What? We were still concealed, so they weren't shooting. I am so confused right now. Oh, because she has a suppressor. Killing did not reveal her, which did not reveal the entire squad. That sucks. I could have killed both of those troopers with Overwatch shots. That really sucks. Killing both of those troopers would have been good. That really sucks. Oh well. We got the sentry. There are faceless there, so... moving in closer is kind of bad. Oh, this isn't cover. Right, this is one of those doodad trees that are just doodads. Because dad do's. And duties. We can move all the way up to here and frag these guys, but we would be so close to the faceless it wouldn't be funny. We can move this way. That won't flank the trooper. We need to get up to here to do that. Which means you can't get to a reliable place to do that from. Can you? Not really. Well, you know what? If we kill the trooper, then they are far enough away that they're probably not going to flank us. So yeah, you can sort of get to a reliable enough place to do that. You probably have a good enough chance to hit him from here. I don't know, is it? You tell me. Yes! Now it is clear.
Okay, so I got one.
Yeah, you did. The loot is in a bad spot, though. I don't think you can move in to pick up this one and this one on the next turn, so that one's going to be tough to get. That first one. I mean, I guess you could move up to here and position yourself for a future turn, but those faceless. The faceless are a problem. A big problem. You don't have access to a shot from where you're at, so yeah. I think... fuck. As much as I don't like the idea of getting that much closer to these guys, can you grenade from here? Probably. Can you grenade from here? For sure, you can grenade from here. Okay, well, tell you what. You can get this far, and you've got piss poor chances of hitting them anyway. So let's move here with you. This is probably fine from the faceless. Yeah. Can you grenade them? Barely the first one. I can hit one of them, and maybe some cover. Or we can flashbang. Okay. So that means you could get up to here or here and probably be in danger from the faceless next turn, because they were like right here, right? Well, let's do it anyway.
I guess that'll be okay.
I guess that'll be okay. I'm just moving closer to, you know... Oh, you'll be fine. That's a dash for them for almost for sure, right? It's gotta be. Might even kill one of these guys. Nope. We did good damage to him, though. For not killing him. Okay, can you get up to there? No, you can't. But you can get here. Which is good. It's a start. So 42% on the guy who has a scope. Yup. I can hail of bullets this. And he's got a scope, so... it probably worth it. This will be the last pod on the map.
All right, I'll go.
But I'm going to use your shot on the guy who has the scope because he has one health.
Not
one damage would have been really sweet Would have been sweet. I can kill this. Well, no, I can't for sure kill this officer with a shot, can I? Well, you know what? You got a 69% to kill him from here, so. Yeah, there you go.
You know that was good.
Yeah, yeah, sure. It wasn't bad. It wasn't great.
Okay.
Move forward and overwatch. Okay, so here's the gamble. I'm actually going to shoot him to save... Well, saving hail of bullets doesn't matter, but it saves overwatch on the gunner who can do more damage to the faceless and could potentially kill the faceless. Okay, nope.
Shot failed to connect.
So, we are going to hail of the bullets. What's your two shot? 42%. That's not bad. But we're not going to do that. We are going to hail of the bullets. Because we want them dead for sure. Mostly dead is not good enough. Now there's a lot of loot on the map, rather. Turn on the loot. There's a lot of loot on the map. Come at me, bros. Come at me. I'm really banking on them being too far away to hurt my guy. That's gotta be a double move, right? It's gotta be. Oh yeah, for show, for show, for show. That's a double move. So they can't hurt him this turn. But killing two faceless is not a small task with just assault rifles on essentially rookies. Hi. Fancy seeing you here. If I had shotguns, this would be a totally different story. Totally different. Totes differente. So you could actually get this loot on one turn. That's cool and nifty and shit. You can't get that one on this turn though, so can you get that one? Oh, you can absolutely for sure get that one. Yeah. You don't have access to a grenade this turn, which sucks, but you can go to here. So we're gonna do that. Good, trust me. I be a doctor. Care trigger and emergency life support. We don't even have Vulture, and we're getting some good shit. Okay, so you're just gonna shoot him. Just shoot. Ooh, man, you probably wanted to hit him. Like, I'm just gonna say, you really probably wanted to hit him.
I'm going.
You're gonna throw a grenade. Not a flashbang grenade, but a grenade.
Boom!
4 to each would be great, 5 to each would be better. Okay, 3 and 4 is not bad. Not bad. It's not a kill. Yeah, we're gonna hardcore grenade these guys.
Heads down.
This is probably gonna fuck us. Okay, we need to do 3 to this one with the next grenade. Actually, there is another soldier back here with a grenade. No, we're fine. We're fine. Actually, I'm tempted to just shoot him then. Let's just shoot him. Please kill. Okay, because we get corpses from these missions, and I want faceless corpses. So, you don't have a grenade. You do have a flashbang, but you could just kill him. He's got 5 health. You do more than 5 damage. Yep, there we go. Faceless corpses are good. I want them. And we got all the loot. Ha ha ha. Fan-fucking-tastic, guys. 7 out of 7, no wounded. I like it. I like it a lot. Flawless work, guys. Tons of loot as well. Advent just brought the loot to us, and I like to see that. Well done. I'll see you guys back at the Avenger. So this is really good, because not only did we eliminate 2 faceless from that haven, we actually, potentially are going to get some of these resistance operatives up a level, which is going to be really good. Like, this one got 2 kills. That's impressive. We got an autoloader, an expanded magazine, a perception, plus 3 aim. Plus aim is awesome, but more would be good. An advanced suppressor, emergency life support, a hair trigger, 4 trooper corpses, an officer corpse, and 2 faceless corpses. That was damn good, ladies and gentlemen. That was damn good. Let's take a... Let's take a quick look at this haven. So we lost some dudes here, but it looks like we got another... we lost 2 people. But it looks like we got another leveled up person. I think we only had 1 before. Maybe we had 2. We probably had 2. I'm probably just crazy. Yeah, flashbanger, precision shot, and you have covering fire and steady hands. I get the feeling you weren't. You probably leveled up. I'm not sure. Advent strength 3. Watch, we're going to get an intel raid right away. That's just going to suck. I really need to get these liberation missions done, and we're going to get an intel raid. That's going to be it for this one, guys. I'll see you next time.